Hey guys, so in this video, we will be showing you how you can use ChatGPT 3's power and its capabilities in your Bubble app. So I have created a quick demo here for you to understand what the video will be about. So let's ask this a question and let's see what it gives us in the response. So let it run through and we will see what it gives us as the result. So here is its results. As you can see, it is very detailed answer, and it even provides us the complete bullet points for how to become a good AI engineer, even if you are not good in math, which is me. So without any waiting time, let's move to the video. So to set up ChatGPT in your Bubble app, what you can do is you can come to this page. I will attach the link in the description down below. So you need to just copy this URL, then you need to have the API connector installed. If you haven't already installed it, you can just search for API connector and then you can install this plugin. Then you have to add a new API and let's say ChatGPT, and then what you can do is you can say ask and then just make it as action, and because it is a post request, we will mark it as post and paste this URL. And then this API requires us, so here's the example that Open API provides us. So we need to have two headers here, as you can see. So one will be the content type, so let's copy this and a header here. And then let me close this. Then for the authorization, let's copy this and then just paste it here. Also for the application, so the content type will be application JSON, and the API key will be bearer and your API key. So let me show you how you can access your API key. So for your API key, you need to go into the personal, view API keys. So once you log in and sign up for the OpenAI, you can come here into the tab and you can see view API keys. Just open it. And here from here, you can come into this API keys part and then you can click on create a new secret key. So I already have a secret key with me here. So I'll just quickly paste it and then we will move to the next section. So I've now pasted my secret key here. So now what we have to do is to close this and come back to this API documentation. So here, as you can see, it provides us, OpenAI provides us a list of many parameters that we can choose. So let's just copy all of these. And then we need to send them into the, in here as well. So note down that the body type is JSON and the model is Text DaVinci. So for the models, you can choose any model that you like. So if you come here in the models, you can see, click this list models. And okay, I think it was in the model overview. Yeah. So as you can, so here you can see different models like ChatGPT-3. So GPT-3 is actually a category of the models. So if you click on GPT-3, we are actually using this model, this specific model, Text DaVinci 003 in our API. So we can, so this prompt will actually be the question. So this will be dynamic and the max tokens will also be dynamic. And then I think we do not need any of these. Let's just remove them. You can learn more about these different parameters in their API, in their API documentation. As you can see, if you come here in the to this link, you can see all of the parameter details and descriptions about each parameter. So we will be using just these for now. And the question will be, so the question again will be this question that we just asked it. So, and then we don't want it private. We do not want the max token as private as well. Let's say that we need 400. So what max token is, you can think of a token as a word. So issuer inputting here 400. So what it will do is the OpenAI will not exceed the limit of tokens more than 400. So let's suppose if the answer was about the needed 2000 tokens, it will just simply not go to 2000s and will just stick on 400. And this is to actually reduce your cost, because API OpenAI charges you per token. So I think we should initialize the call now and see what it gives us in the result. You cannot pass the in the community search was using HTML library. This will be load. Okay, I think we have missed something here. Okay, we need to remove this comma here. And let's try this again. Okay, we have not received the complete answer from ChatGPT. So we'll just ignore these fields. Just ignore these fields. So this is the actual answer that we need. And then we'll ignore these as well. And then just save answer. So if you click on manually enter, you can see we will get the choices from this, and then we need text from this API whenever we will be using it. So I have already prepared this front end. So now if we go into this design part, we can actually use this API that we just built. So when we click on this button, it should get the value of this input. And let's copy this. So if I start and I do workflow, so this was the plugin that we were building from Chakor. So if you say, so this is the API that we have just built. It is named Chakor GPT Ask. And we can input dynamic value here. And dynamic value should be inputs value. And then what we can do is we will pass the, so let me just clear this before. So result of step 2 is choices and first items text. So this is how you will get the response. And all I'm doing is I'm actually displaying the response that will come through this API into, and let me just show you, into this ChatGPT 3 answers. So let me just close this as well. So all I'm doing is I'm showing the answer in this text. And then what I'm doing is I am showing the answer here through the parent group. So let's come back here and see if it works. Should I learn Google I/O in 2023, and let's ask it, and then let's just wait for its response. So as you can see, we have just received a answer from the ChatGPT 3. So it just answered us completely. So I think I need to remove this as well. And then let's just ask it again. Awesome. So you can remove these text later. I think these are little bugs that will come. So this is the complete answer that that ChatGPT gives us. So that's all for this video now. Thank you so much for connecting today, and keep watching Bubble Chakor's Bubble tutorials for more. Thank you so much.